Hi, in this video I'm going to introduce to you a type of time series model known as the ARIMAX model. So in this particular playlist you might have gone through the different types of ARIMA model like AR, AMA, ARMA and ARIMA, so the class of models known as the ARIMA. Which stands for autoregressive integrated moving average, so which has got the autoregressive component, the moving average component and so on. So ARIMAX model is a variation of the ARIMA model. So there is only one extra component to it, the X. Okay, so what does X stand for? The X stands for the X variables or the explanatory variable or the input variable. Remember, if you know what is ARIMA class of model, you would have known that ARIMA class of models are the univariate models. Univariate, right? So what ARIMA does is that it takes the past values of yt and the error terms to forecast for the future values of the time series model. Okay. And it doesn't use any explanatory variable or input variable as such. But sometimes in macroeconomic forecasting or other kind of forecasting, you will come across cases where it is not only the past trend, it is not only the past trend or the past historical trend of the same variable, it is also the input variables like unemployment, sometimes inflation, political changes, natural calamity. We'll say you are forecasting some sort of an index, okay, you're forecasting some stock index, okay. So it might not be only it's the past values of the index, it also could be the employment, the inflation, political changes. So these variables could be the extra variables or the input variables or the explanatory variable, which could also affect the changes in the values of index. It is not only the past values of index which is important for forecasting its future values. It also depends on other factors like unemployment, inflation and so on. So how do we include explanatory variable in a univariate time series model forecasting? So that's done by a special type of ARIMA model known as ARIMAX model. So ARIMAX models, ARIMA is a special type of ARIMA model with explanatory variables. So if you know the multivariate time series models, sorry, multivariate models, so structural models or regression models, y equal to beta naught plus beta 1 x, you know that x is nothing but explanatory variables. So when we include this explanatory variable in univariate model, we call that as ARIMAX model. Okay. So this form of that model is like this. You estimate the future value of y, which is your time series, with the past values of y, so that's the univariate component, and then input variables. Okay, it could be a number of x variables, which could be unemployment, inflation or any other variable. So these are the input variables. Or more formally, we represent an ARIMAX model like this. Yt is a combination of C, which is constant, and then V of B, Xt. Xt is the number of time series. There could be a number of time series model, not just one time series model. And VB is just in some kind of an estimate estimate which takes a distributed form, hence it is known as the impulse response function. So we'll talk more about the impulse response function in another video. We'll also show how we estimate an ARIMA model, ARIMAX model. So the VB is some sort of a constant associated with XT, known as the impulse response function or also known as the transfer function. Okay, and NT is is the stochastic error terms, which is independent of XT and which is also white noise in nature. So this is the ARIMAX models. So the main thing that is that one should learn or one should know in the ARIMAX model is that it includes the input variables, which is not found in ARIMA model. The advantage of this model is that it performs better than the ARIMA model in cases where your time series is dependent on input variables or factors. Okay, and sometimes you might use both ARIMA and ARIMAX and compare the results or outputs in order to be able to get more accurate forecasting results. Thank you, and please subscribe to our channel. Please go to our website, which is in the link is in the description section. Thank you. Thanks for the subscription.